Hanse-Himarwa is accused of removing names of two people who were to benefit from the mass housing program and replace them with her relatives during her stint as Hardap governor. During his testimony today, Taniseb informed the High Court that shortly after a team of officials from the Mariental Town Council, National Housing Enterprise and the Ministry drafted a final list of beneficiaries, they approached Hanse-Himarwa to brief her on the progress of identifying the beneficiaries as a courtesy prior to the handover on the 17th of December 2014. During this meeting, Hanse-Himarwa expressed unhappiness over the criteria applied and her exclusion in the selection of beneficiaries before questioning the authenticity of the list, he added. They explained that the criteria applied was also used in towns such as Wolfish Bay and Oshakati, where such houses were also handed over. Taniseb said Hanse-Himarwa responded that whatever happened in other towns was not her concern and that they will apply their own set of processes for the Hardap region. Taniseb revealed that shortly afterwards, Hanse-Himarwa proposed two new names, both of which are her relatives, by stating that they are physically handicapped and in dire need of housing. The names were subsequently added to the list and two other people were removed under the pretext that they will get houses in the next phase the following year. On Tuesday, his colleague also testified that they were also informed by the chief executive officer of the Mariental Town Council at the time that the name changes were spearheaded by Hanse-Himarwa. Taniseb also indicated that although Hanse-Himarwa has no powers to change the list, they were forced to amend the list with the names she put forth because she occupies a higher office as governor. He added that Hanse-Himarwa also questioned why people campaigning against SWAPO should be given houses at the expense of SWAPO party sympathizers. The trial continues.